Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, EULA. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. So from that subject, from unit number 4, that is case study on solar energy application, we have covered first case study, that is case study related to the solar food dryer. Then from the last lecture, we have started the second case study, that is the parabolic dish solar cookers. So related to that parabolic dish solar cooker, we have discussed some topics in the last lecture. So let's see which topics we have discussed and which topic we have to discuss in the today's lecture. So in the last lecture, we have discussed what is the solar cookers. And related to the solar cooker, what is the its use, then which are its type, all basic details we have seen in the last lecture. So in the today's lecture, we are going to see the next point, that is the working principle of solar cookers and application of solar cookers. So let's see, without wasting the time, let's see what is the working principle of solar cookers. So basically, if you know the solar cookers, in the last lecture I have shown you one diagram related to the solar cooker, that is the parabolic dish solar cooker. So how it is working, that also I have explained in the last lecture, but in the today's lecture again we are going to continue the working principle of solar cooker. So basically, that solar cookers are working in the three steps. Out of that, first step is concentrating sunlight. First step in the solar cooker working principle is nothing but the concentrating the solar or concentrating the sunlight. That is the first step. Second step, once sunlight get concentrated, second step is there, that is the converting light energy into the heat energy. That means for the cooker or cooking the foods, we should require the heat energy. For that purpose, what we have to do, the solar energy which we have concentrated, we have to convert it into the heat energy. And third step is nothing but the trapping heat energy. That means once sunlight get converted into the heat energy, in the second step, third step is nothing but the trapping the heat energy. That means by utilizing that heat energy, we have to cook our food. All of you understand? That is nothing but the third step in the working principle of solar cooker. So let's see that all step one by one in the details. So first step is nothing but the concentrating sunlight. So how to concentrate sunlight, that here is explained. So let's see, a mirror surface with high specular reflection is used to concentrate the light from the sun into the small cooking area. That means in the cooking area, we have used mirror surface with high specular reflection for concentrating the sunlight. All of you understand that? Depending on the geometry of the surface, sunlight could be concentrated by several order of magnitude, producing temperature high enough to melt salt and metals. All of you understand that? That means depending on the shape of the concentrated plate, there will be the amount of sunlight concentrated. For most household solar cooking application, such high temperatures are not really required. That means in the household cooking application, too much high temperature is not required. So we can use the solar concentrated there. Solar cooking products are typically designed to achieve the temperature of 65 degrees Celsius, that is near around 150 degree Fahrenheit. Baking temperatures and 400 degrees Celsius, that is 750 degree Fahrenheit, that is nothing but the grilling or searing temperatures on a sunny day. That means with the help of solar concentrated, we can achieve the heat or we can achieve the temperature up to 65 to 400 degree Celsius. That is nothing but the concentrating sunlight. So for concentrating sunlight, we have used the concentrators. And depending on the shape of the concentrator, there will be the amount of sunlight concentrated. Then once sunlight get concentrated, we have to use it for cooking the foods. So second step is nothing but the converting light energy to the heat energy. Because with the help of light energy, we cannot cook the food. We have to convert that heat light energy into the heat energy so we can cook the food. So solar cooker concentrate sunlight into onto a receiver such a cooking pan. The interaction between the light energy and the receiver materials converts light to heat, and this is called as a conduction. That means the solar energy concentrated by the concentrated plate, that is converted into the heat energy, that is called as a conduction. The conversion is maximized by using the material that conduct and retain the heat. That means the conversion of sunlight energy into the heat energy is depend on the materials of the concentrated plate used. Pot and pan used for the solar cooker should be made black in the color to maximize the absorption. That means the dark black color should be used to maximize the absorption of the sunlight. All of you understand that? That is nothing but the light energy to the heat energy conversion. Once heat energy is converted, we have to use that heat energy and we have to cook our food. That means the third step is nothing but trapping the heat energy for cooking the food. So what they have said about trapping the heat energy? It is important to reduce convection by isolating the air inside the cooker from the cooker outside the cookers. All of you understand? So simply using a glass lid on your pot enhances the light absorption from the top of the pan and provides a greenhouse effect that improves heat retention and maximize convection loss. All of you understand? Convection loss will be the minimized. So this glazing transmits incoming visible sunlight, but it opaques to the escaping infrared thermal radiation. In resources constrained setting, a high temperature plastic bag can serve a similar function, trapping the air inside and making it possible to reach the temperature on cold and windy days similar to those possible on the hot days. That means in the third step, generally what we are doing, we are trapping the heat energy which is converted from sunlight to the heat energy for cooking the foods. That is nothing but the third step involved in the working of principle of the solar cooker. That means solar cooker generally work in the three steps, that is concentrating the sunlight. Once sunlight get concentrated, we have to convert it into the heat energy, and once sunlight get converted into heat energy, we have to trap the maximum energy for cooking the foods. That is nothing but the working principle. I think all of you understand that working principle of the solar cooker. The next point is related to the application of solar cooker. So solar cooker may be applied or may be used in the different field. So some fields are noted here, which are that water distillation plants. So for driving the water distillation plant, solar cookers are used. That means for water distillation purpose, solar cookers are used. Then solar smelting, then roasting the coffee and nuts for the commercial purposes, separation of bee wax and the capping. Wax melting also solar cookers are used. Then sterilization of medical apparatus, solar cookers are used. Grain sterilization also solar cookers are used. Ironing, water purification and dehydration purpose, solar cookers are used. That means that are some applications where solar cookers are used. So related to that, all points in the details, water distillation, all points, details, how solar cookers are used, that are given. So let's see, water distillation plants, how solar cookers are used. We use the setup for distillation of water to with the help of the parabolic cooker along with the distiller setup above the pot receptacle for the keeping the water constantly boiling. That means in the water distillation plant, what we are doing, we are boiling the waters to remove the various content from the waters. So for that purpose, solar cookers are used for boiling the water. So in the water distillation plant, solar cooker are used. Then solar smelting, the restoring the coffees and nooms for the commercial purpose, also we are using the solar cooker. Then one of the important application of the solar cooker is nothing but the wax melting. So commercial use of the melting and reforging wax from the leftover wax and waste wax is done using the solar cooker. That means waste wax is melted by the solar cookers and it is again comes into the use. So it is one of the important application of the solar cooker, that is wax melting. Sterilization of medical apparatus, that means all of you know, for sterilization, that means for cleaning or making the germs free of the different apparatus of the medical apparatus, we are using the sterilization process. So for that the boiled water is required and that is done by with the help of solar cookers. So in the solar cooker we are sterilizing the different medical apparatus. Then green sterilization also there. Ironing, for ironing purpose use the old style hot iron is not ideal, not compared to the heating the iron on the parabolic cooker which gets hot enough and fast enough to ironing process. That means nowadays we are not using that solar cooker for ironing, but in the solar cookers we can use the ironing process as faster as possible. Then water purification purpose also that solar cookers are used, and in the last dehydration purpose solar cookers are used. So for domestic use, search a dehydration food in the solar box style in which the vents are partially open for circulation of air and also the lid or door are partially open to prevent the excess heating. That is nothing but the dehydration process solar cookers are used. That means that are some applications where solar cookers are used. So I think all of you understand that different application. Now the remaining points, that are advantages of solar cooker, disadvantages of solar cooker, types of solar cooker, and actual case study of solar cooker. Sorry, here dryer is written, but actual case study related to the solar cooker, that also we have to see in the upcoming lecture.